Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode here on African Confessions. The following story that you're going to be listening to, it comes from a translation of a message that I received. The translation, it reads like this. Hello, Brother Nanshi, how are you? Can you please post my own story as hidden identity? My brother, my story, it goes on like this. My name is Tatenda, not my real name. When I came here to South Africa, I was still very young. This was after my mom had gotten married to a man who was staying here in South Africa. And then I went to school, and after that, I then went to university where I got my scholarship because of the way that I was really bright and intelligent when I was in school. So because of my brilliance, there was this other professor who liked me a lot. He was the one who made me to join an occultic club, and I started going to that occultic club, and so much that even people who know me, they don't even understand that this is what I do. I even go to church, and I even got married to a woman who loves God a lot, and she has no idea that the man that she is staying with is an occultic man, and I have been living a double life for years now. So when we came here to South Africa, we were still very young. And from a very young age, I knew that I wanted to pursue a career in videography. After getting accepted at the University of Johannesburg, I found myself immersed in the world of filmmaking and music production. And the professor by my side, I thought that he was just giving me guidance. I thought that I was lucky because amongst his students, he had chosen me. I thought that I was really lucky. But and now I don't know if we can say it is luck when the devil has chosen you to be on his side. I started to build my name, a name for myself, working on various music video shoots for both upcoming, and then I started doing video shoots now for very famous musicians. But what most people don't know about me is that I am part of a secret cult. So this secret cult has deeply infiltrated the entertainment industry. Like most of the people, they always hear about the Illuminati. They think that once you go to any recording studio, immediately you're going to be taken straight to the headquarters of the Illuminati. That is not how things work. Most of the musicians, some of them that you see showing the devil in their music videos, it is that they don't even know what they will be doing. Some of them, they will be shocked by the time that we would have finished editing the video. When we show them the video for the first time, I have seen some artists that will be like, what the hell is this? Was I the one who told you to do this? But it is because when you are signed to a record label, some of the things that you do, it will be scripted. So most of the people end up saying that this artist is an Illuminati, this one is an Illuminati. They don't even understand what the hell they are talking about. It is not everyone who is part of a secret cult when you are in the entertainment industry. You can even be in a movie that is all about praising the devil without you even realizing that you are taking part in a satanic ritual as a famous actor or a famous musician. So I joined the cult during my university days. At first, when the professor told me that those that are intelligent, they have to be part of secret organizations, and I was so happy because he was comparing me with some of the greatest minds in the entertainment industry. At first, I thought that it was harmless. We were going to be sharing secrets with those that had the maturity, just a group of young people being connected to others that were very mature. But when I started to see that there was a lot of homosexuality that was taking place, men dating men, this made me to even question. When I was about to leave, that was when I was told that the scholarship was going to be pulled out because I did not want to date another man who was quite old. At that time, we were supposed to go to America, and it was my dream for me to go to America. So that was when I was told that in order for me to go to America with the rest of the group, there was this other man in Joburg who had requested that I go and sleep at his house. I cried when I was taken by the driver as I was being driven to that house. It was somewhere around 9 p.m. The streets were quiet as if everyone was mourning for what was about to happen to me. I was taken to that man's house, and that man, he had his way with me as if I was his wife. But as time went on, Brother Nanshi, I got so used to it. That was when I learned that there were many steps that we needed to complete to be members of this occultic group. And we then learned that there were much more things that were going on behind the scenes. This was not just a creative circle. It was an occult group with a very specific agenda. They slowly pulled me in with the money and the trips around the world, showing me how they control the media and entertainment to spread messages that most people can't see or understand, but every human being is able to understand, like subliminal messages. So we were taught how to place those subliminal satanic messages in music videos, hidden symbols, signs, and gestures that can get noticed by the casual viewer. Even the famous musicians that I have worked with, most of them, if we are targeting their fans, they won't even realize that these are some of the things that we are placing in their videos. We hide this symbol so well that they blend into the background of the videos, but the human mind, like your soul, will be able to pick up those tiny, tiny little details without you even noticing that this is what is happening. And the impact can be very real, whether it is a quick flash of an inverted cross, a subtle hand gesture, or a shadow shaped like the devil himself. And we were taught how to perfect the art of sending messages without anyone suspecting. There was one time when I worked with this other man, so he wanted a gospel music video for one of his songs. He's a very well-known South African artist. The whole video was meant to be about praising God, but then we turned the whole video around. What we did is that we then inserted a satanic cross into one of the scenes. It was something that cannot even be recognized by those that do not understand. So we placed this satanic cross at the back of the other cross, the Jesus cross, and we placed it in the background in the form of a shadow. But it being there, even though no one noticed, not the artist, the producer, even the fans, they won't even know what exactly they are looking at, but we knew what we had done. The idea is slowly to desensitize people to these symbols, making them more acceptable in the mainstream culture. At first, I was uncomfortable with it, especially the part of placing these symbols even in music videos that are all about God and praising God and worshiping God. I thought that it was just pure blasphemy, but I was told that this was my job. This was the reason as to why the organization had to sponsor me when I was still in varsity, and I was promised more and more. And if I followed their path, I was going to become a wealthy man. And yes, indeed, Brother Nanshi, I am someone who has a lot of money. As time went on, it's almost like I became numb to the things that we do. It is just like a part of my job. We can sit behind the camera knowing that we are inserting messages that can lead people astray, that can lead people even to committing suicide. Yes, by some of the shadows that we place in the background of the music videos, it can trigger, like if someone is under the possession of a demon, so that the doors to their soul can be opened up, then the demon that can make a person want to commit suicide will be able to enter and do its job. And it is like we do not care anymore. The money is good, Brother Nanshi, but there was this other day when I was watching this other video that I was the main director for that video. When I watched that video, Brother Nanshi, I felt so bad. I really felt bad about what I had done. Now that I am sitting here looking at all the wealth that I have had, knowing that some of these things that I have done, it is not easy for me to walk away. Once you are in, they don't just let you walk away. I have seen things that have happened to some musicians that have realized that their own music was being used to promote satanic things in their videos, I've seen those artists as they will be perishing in accidents, sudden death, careers being ruined overnight, simply because a person would have realized that, no, my video, why is it all of a sudden it is like it's all about worshipping the devil, yet I'm not even into this thing of pentagrams and signs and whatnot. Then when that artist tried to raise their voice, then they will be silenced, accident, sudden death, or your career can be ruined overnight. That is why most musicians, they choose to remain quiet if they come across such things in their music videos. Dear listeners, right there was a message that was sent to me by one of our dear brother. That was the translation of the message that was sent to me. Please let us try to speak with our dear brother in the comment section. Yo, strange things indeed they do happen in this world. You were saying that they place little symbols that the musician won't even notice that this is what is happening in my music video. Yo,